What's good, true gamers? It's your boy, Sega Man, back with another pickups video. I've got a few things I want to show and talk about that I picked up, man. I hope everybody is doing well, you know? And I want to give a shout out, man, to my crew that I've been rocking out with day one. You know what I'm saying? I want to give a shout out to my brother E-Rock, the Don King of Xbox. My brother Unlimited Productions, Hebot, Tuckmaster, and ODT Reaper. You know what I'm saying? Big shouts out to them brothers, man. I hope they're doing good. Excuse me, enjoying gaming. I want to give a big shout out to Intro Media Gaming, with my brother 100 and the crew, Flip the Script, Flip Money, Chaos, all those brothers over there, man. Big shouts out to them, you know, out there in these Xbox streets. You know what I mean? And everybody that's a true gamer out there, no matter if you're on the PC, you know, on the Xbox, you know, the true gamers that, you know, like the Nintendo and the PlayStation consoles, you know, and their games, you know. Big shouts out to them. You know what I mean? They like what they rock, and that's what it's all about. You know what I mean? So, we will be back with another Xbox Alpha podcast this Saturday, guys. I'm just busy. You know, I'm a full-time worker and father. You know what I mean? So I have to take care and do family things first. You know, so there might be some weekends where there might not be an Alpha podcast. Doesn't mean it disappeared or dissipated and that it went away. You know, but sometimes I have things I gotta take care of, and that comes first. You know what I mean? My family values, things I gotta do come before gaming. I mean, that's just the way it is. You know what I mean? So I just wanted to let you guys know that. And excuse me, guys, excuse me. There will definitely be another podcast coming up this weekend. So we will be talking about new games that are coming into Game Pass. I've been playing the Mass Effect Legendary, I think, trilogy that came in Game Pass. It's awesome. They did an incredible job on the graphics and the color lighting. Microsoft is just, you know, they're just really doing a good service, man, to people that are diehard Xbox fans. They really are. You know what I mean? We'll talk about the new Rainbow Six game that'll be in there day one. Talking about Ubisoft coming in, I guess being part of Game Pass. You know what I mean? Like EA. You know, there'll be other things that we're going to talk about too. You know what I mean? But big shouts out to everybody that rocks out with your boy Sega Man. You know what I'm saying? Lord, Craig Simmons, TV. Big shouts out to Lewis L. You know, Rain G4. You know, Peltrex. Just all you guys that, you know, that rock out with your boy Sega Man. You know what I mean? Everybody's not gonna like everything you say in a podcast. That's what makes a podcast good. You know what I mean? You disagree or you agree. You know what I mean? And that's what keeps us going out here. You know, in the gaming world, you know, on Xbox podcasts and, you know, other gaming podcasts, you know what I mean? So, we just love talking about gaming. And yes, we will call out the bull crap also. But when it comes down to it, you know, your boy Sega Man is a, you know, OG collector of games and systems. And, you know, Xbox is my brand of choice, and I will defend it. You know, no matter what. So, being said, man, I picked up a couple more back and pack games physically for the Xbox Series X, man. You know what I mean? And I got these at a really good price also. You know what I mean? One I think was $11. Excuse me, and one was like $6. You know what I mean? So we're gonna get into that real quick. Then I'm going to show you a couple of things I picked up at my local Big Lots that you might not have known about. We're going to go into that also. So I know you guys really come to see the podcast, or if I do, Sega Man Hangouts, but it's good to do other things on your channel, man. Doing game pickups. I might even do maybe a couple of videos talking about, low budget cheesy horror movies that I picked up at the Dollar Tree and talking about them a little bit. You know what I mean? But mainly my channel's basically a gaming channel. You know what I mean? But I like to dib and dab and do different things on my channel, man. Sometimes you got to switch it up a little bit. You know what I mean? So let's get into the first game I found, man. This is called, and it's complete in box with a slip cover. It was $11. This is called The First Templar. Now, I found this game from Goodwill Books. You need to check out Goodwill Books, man. They don't just have books, and you might think that the website is boring, and it's not. You can find great books to read, and you can find music, DVDs, and games. For people that don't know, check out Goodwill Books to find OG games and even Xbox One games and PlayStation and Nintendo. You can find games there, sometimes cheap, sometimes it might be higher price. But if you're definitely collecting for OG Xbox games and OG GameCube or whatever games like PlayStation 2 or 1, you could find some better deals on Goodwill Books than sometimes even Lukey Games, to be honest with you. Lukey Games is still probably the number one place, but try Goodwill Books. And I'm adding this to the backwards compatibility catalog that I already have. And it came with a slip cover, right? Slip cover. Now these games have actually went up in price. I mean, I think you can find it probably for $15, $20, which isn't still that bad. You know what I mean? It's not like it's 50 cent blood money on the sand. That game is outrageously priced. I'm glad I had it. I had it for a long time, but that game is super expensive. Red Dead Revolver, different games like that, unless you buy it digitally on the Xbox, I think it's $14.99. But this is awesome. And it came complete with the book and everything, and like some, I think, original stuff that that came in the game. The disc is flawless. The disc is flawless, man. Flawless. It came with the booklet. It came with, like, I don't know, I guess, things that were in the game. Sometimes you don't get these things in the games anymore when you collect, like, brochures and, and advertising about different types of games. Like Air Conflict, Secret War, different kind of games like that from the company, you know what I mean, that made the First Templar. Like, it even has that little advertisement in it. You know what I mean? Look like you can win some Turtle Beach headphones, different things like that. And this Tropico 4, which was actually free with Games with Gold, I think last month. You know what I mean? I'm not really into games like that, but that's cool. It doesn't really mean much to some people, but they put advertisement in there about other games that they make besides this game to see that might pique your interest and maybe picking up those games. So that's cool to have this complete. The book, if you look, is flawless. There's no bents or anything like it was hardly played. You know what I mean? You usually get the booklet all, ruffled up from people trying to get it out, or ripped, or something happened to it, or or something like that. But that's cool to actually get this with the slip cover, with the with the price that it cost, which was $11, which isn't bad. You know what I mean? So yeah, that's the First Templar. Now this looks like a great like hack and slash, like medieval game. So I can't wait to get in to this game. Let me know in the comment section, brothers, if you've had this game or you have it, and what you think about it, and is it a good game to you? You know what I mean? So that's an awesome thing, man, that to pick that up for the price. So the next one we got which is a family type game. You know what I mean? This was, I think it was $6, either $6 or $8. I can't remember. I don't have the my price, my slip with me, the receipt. This is another game that is from Goodwill Games called Disney Universe. It's another one. I think I previously owned this. I can't remember if I played a demo, but it's not a bad game actually to play, or have, play with your kids also. You know what I mean? But some of these Disney games out here are great for adults to play also. They're very fun, have good fun factor. You know what I mean? Great, cutie like graphics. You know what I mean? Everything doesn't have to be hack and slash. You know what I mean? You have to dibble and dabble in different types of games to be a collector and to also be a connoisseur and love gaming. You can't just play shoot 'em ups and hack and slashes and games like that. You have to broaden your horizons and you need to try different games, in my opinion. And Disney always make great, beautiful games, fun, friendly games for you to play by yourself or to play with your family, man. Sometimes when you play games like this, it's a good family bond with your kids, while they're growing up. It's like an entry, entry form into gaming. You know what I mean? Playing games like this, and Disney made some really good games, on the Xbox 360, man. They really did, and they continue to make pretty beautiful graphical, like games like this, and so does like a Pixar and different ones like that. They make really good fun games, man. And I picked this up for that a really good price, which was $6 or $8. This is back compat, and this one also is complete, and I'm very happy to say that. That's really cool, with the little booklet in there. The game is also in a really great condition, man. You know what I mean? Sometimes it's hard to get these games, in good condition. Some of them will be really like have light wear and tear, but still are playable. And they let you know that in the description when you go to order these games to choose whether or not if you want to buy it. But it's not going to hurt your system. All it's doing is reading the information into there, and then you just put it in and play it. It's not like it's spinning in there, you know what I mean? So, and it's not going to hurt anything, you know what I mean? Now, if it's really super scratched up, has big gouges in it, like it was, getting cut by a, by the chainsaw gun and gears, then no, you're not going to want it, you know what I mean? Or, being stepped on or whatever. You know what I mean? So, or used for a coaster, for your beer or whatever, But it looks like a really fun game, man. And I want to try to get in everything that was physical that came out last year when they introduced all the 76 games. I want to try to get everything physical. You know what I mean? Now I got digital stuff too, but I want to try to get all the physical games if I can. For the backwards compatibility, great backwards compatibility that we have on the Xbox, man. Very happy with what Phil Spencer and him are doing with the back compat, man. I'm loving it, man. I'm loving it. Like the Fair games. I seen Fair 3, man. They want like $80 for that game. I seen. I'm like, God damn, 80, $50. I mean, but they did a really good job. Remastering the game on it, the graphics they made, they improved everything. That's what's great about a backwards compatibility team for Xbox, man. They do a fantastic job, and they're number one in the business. No other game company can really compare, honestly, to the backwards compatibility team with Xbox. So, hats off to them. You know what I mean? So, going forward, I was in my local Big Lots, man. I was looking around. Sometimes I like to try to find, really decent priced Blu-rays and stuff there. Really, they have good prices on them. They're not too expensive at all, but really didn't find anything. You know what I mean? I found this cheesy movie. I didn't want to show it in the video called The movie was only 75 cents, man. Believe it or not, it was only 75 cents. I like them cheesy horror sci-fi movies. It's called RoboCroc. It's called RoboCroc. So if you go to your Big Lots, you might find it for 75 cents, man, if you like them cheesy sci-fi horror flicks. It might be really bad, but it could be a bad that's really good. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna check it out. RoboCroc, man. You know what I mean? Something you probably would watch or find on the sci-fi channel. You know what I mean? So I picked that up. But the biggest thing I picked up there, guys and girls, I picked up, if you like, or you are a big Halo Infinite fan, or a fan of Halo in general, I picked up a few things from there that were not badly priced at all. Hebot does a lot of videos, showing off, statues, figures that he buys. A lot of stuff that Hebot shows, it doesn't come cheap. It's very expensive, very high quality stuff, man. You know what I mean? And some people might not be able to afford to buy some of those figures and statues that Hebot collects. So if you want to go a little bit of a cheaper route, you could for decent quality if you're into collecting stuff like that. I'm not super duper into collecting figures and statues, but when it's game related, if I can find it for a good price for me, I will collect it. So I found a couple Halo, believe it or not, action figures, man. And I'll tell you the story about the first one here. Now, this is the Halo Infinite Set 1 UNSC. This is the Halo Infinite Hydra Launcher USNC Marine from Halo Infinite right here. Check that out. Check out the back. It has really, nice artwork on the back. Shows you the other figures that you can get down there. But this is, I picked this up at Big Lots, man. Yeah, the lighting is going to be bad on it. But I took it to the front and I told the brother that was ringing me up. I said, there was no price on this, man. Can you give me a price for it? So he tried to, ring it in, and it wasn't coming up at all. It wasn't coming up. He tried to manually put it in on his, on his register, and it wasn't coming up. And there was a line starting to form. This is the truth, and you can't have no lines there. Because I used to work there way back when. You know what I mean? Your manager will get mad at you. You need to either call somebody or just, try to find a price check or whatever. Right? But there was no, it wasn't in the system at all. Couldn't find the price. So he said, "Hey, how about if I just give it to you for like $5?" And I said, "You ain't gonna get in trouble, are you?" He's like, "Nah, I can't find it, man. I scanned it a few times, I punched it in, I can't find it." So he gave this to me. Where I bought it for $5. And I just said, as long as you don't get in trouble, that's cool. But yeah, it is the Halo Infinite US UNSC Marine, man, with the Hydra launcher. And you might not be able to see it well on here, but it's very detailed for what it is. You know what I mean? But it has to do with Halo Infinite. And that's why I bought it. You know what I mean? So I'm trying to get it in here so you can kind of see it, but with the glare, it's kind of hard. But go to your local Big Lots, man. You might find, some Halo figures, man, for a good price. Now I'm pretty sure that probably was, I'm gonna say about $15. That's just off the top of my head. It could have been around $15, you know what I mean? But he gave it to me for five because he couldn't find the price. Now, these other two figures that I got from there are very well detailed, in my opinion. You know what I mean? For the price they're asking for these two other figures that I got. And these were priced, and they were 10 bucks. But it has to deal, like I said, with Halo Infinite. And to celebrate Halo Infinite, also, because I like Halo, not just Gears. Gears is my favorite. But I found a Spartan figure. I think it's Calvalion or Cavalio. But this was $10 at your local Big Lots, man. You know what I mean? He's got a little stand in the background, if you can see there, his gun. You know what I mean? And there's the figure. You know what I mean? He's pretty detailed. You know what I mean? He's not going to be like statue or figure detailed like you would pay for some of those ones that are like $50, $60, you know, some $100, $120 figures. You know what I mean? $80. You know what I mean? But he's, for the price, it's not bad. It has a really good casing in it. It shows you the other figures that are on the back. So it is good to collect, you know, like game stuff like this for a good price. You know what I mean? So you can't beat it, guys. So go to your local Big Lots, man. And if you like Halo Infinite and you want to spruce up your, you know, your game room or your room where you play your games, try to find some of these figures, man, and display them, you know, in your gaming room. It'll still look nice, you know, at a reasonable price. You know what I mean? So that's not bad. You know what I mean? And, yeah, I was happy to get that. There's another one down there. If it's still down there, I might get it, you know, this Friday if it's still there. If it's not there, oh well. So the next one I got here is an elite mercenary, you know, with Pulse, the Pulse gun on here. Right now, this one is very detailed, too. You know what I mean? This is from the Halo Infinite series. You know what I mean? He looks really good, man. He did a really good job, like I said, for the price. But check him out, man. You might not be able to see him well, but check him out. You know what I mean? He's pretty detailed. I like the blue and black color on him. There's his little gun right there, and then you got the stand right there that's in the back. You know what I mean? So if you want to, like, you know, like I said, take them out of the boxes, you know what I mean, and display them on their, you know, their little, you know, their little stands that they have, which is cool. Now, me, myself, man, this being the Halo figures, I might kind of just keep them in the case and hang them up. That's another thing. You can hang these up. You don't even have to open them, you know, to keep the value of it up. You know what I mean? So I think I'm going to find a place in my game room, and I think I'm just going to hang these up. Now, this one I'm going to actually, I might have to actually take this one out. You know what I mean? There's no hang tab or anything like that. So I might take him out and display him. But these ones I think I'm going to hang up. But like I said, for $10, you honestly can't beat it. Go to your local Big Lots, man, and see if you can find these figures. If you do, let me know in the comment section if you found them or picked them up. Like my brother NWO Prime, a long time ago, I found these Halo Infinite, like, plush pillows at Five and Below. And he went out and got them. And he said, thanks for the tip, Sega man. And he sent me a picture of it. So to spruce up your game, your gaming room, you know, your gaming den or whatever, it doesn't have to be expensive to do it. There's other ways you can make it look nice, like I said, for a cheaper price, man. So check them out. Check out your local Big Lots, man. And that's all I have for today, guys. Man, I will definitely probably see you guys sometime this Saturday. If it's not going to be Saturday, if something comes up, it'll definitely be Sunday. It's just this weekend has been really, really busy, the last past weekend. So, you know, with family and things like that, man. You know what I mean? But we will be back with another Alpha podcast. You know, come and join us on there and join us on our other podcast, the Exile Podcast, when we do the next one with my brother, the Donking of Xbox, E-Rock X, and the whole Exile and Alpha crew. Come and rock out with us, man. Like I said, there's a few good topics to talk about this weekend that's already probably been talked about, but we're going to talk about it on the Alpha and talk about some other things. And I just want to give a big shout out to my subscribers, man. I really appreciate you guys that rock out with me. You know what I mean? If new ones come and rock out with me, man, I'm very appreciative towards that. You know what I'm saying? Really much respect to all you guys that come and hang out with me, man. I'm going to get back on giving out some more goodies also, you know, some more gaming gift cards and things like that. With the holidays, it's a little harder. You know, I have to take care of family first and things like that, you know. But when I can, I will do another giveaway of a $15 gift card or $10 gift card or something like that. Sometimes maybe like even a $25, or something like that. But it's something, you know what I mean, that can help you to purchase something at the Microsoft store that you might want or like, gaming related or whatever. You know what I mean? So you guys take care, man. And just be safe out there, guys. Enjoy gaming. You know what I mean? Like I said, Xbox is, they're really doing, they're just really doing great by us, man. You know what I mean? In my opinion. Yes, I still have those, trolls and naysayers out there that, they want to try to, damage control and talk about me and stuff like that. But that's okay, man. They just show me that they don't have a life. You know what I mean? They don't have nothing better to do. You know what I mean? So it's all good. It makes me feel good because I know that you're paying attention to me and you're coming to my channel and checking me out. So keep on doing that. You know what I mean? You'll just keep getting ignored. You know what I mean? You must like coming here. So when you come here, clicked on my channel. You know what I mean? So hey, it's all good, man. Like I said, you're not gonna get no shine here. You're not gonna get no response, man. No, this is a true Xbox gamer that you'll never ever be able to change my mind about anything. I'm a grown ass man, and I like what I like. If you don't like what I have to say, get the hell out. All right? Peace and love, guys. Xbox for life. We don't die, we multiply. We're eating good over here. Peace. Like that?